What up, y'all? Hey, what's up, Trump supporters? It's me again, GI Operation on Twitter, CEO of BlackFolkHotspots.com. I see you guys didn't too much like my video about why y'all defending Donald Trump over John Lewis, a true patriot. A guy that risked his life. Risk, R-I-S-K. So don't mistake how to spell it, because I know a lot of y'all can't even spell. I've been looking through the comments of the last post I posted. And so I'm going to ask y'all a question. Does Donald Trump love this country more than he loves money? Does Tillerson love this country more than he loves oil money? Now, you can go on and on. You can call me racist. You can call me whatever. That's not even possible. But, you know, you can be an idiot, you know, which a lot of y'all are. But ask yourself that question. Matter of fact, go ask him that question. And you know what the answer is to prove it? Divest. Sell everything. And take the little, to him, the presidential salary. Don't give it, don't pass it to your kids in some BS new entity that you created. Show us some BS papers. Show us your taxes. Hell, that'll be a first, that'll be a start. Release the taxes. You can release them under audit. Because I'm going to tell y'all something. Y'all some damn fools if you think that that man loves this country more than he loves money. He ain't a patriot. And I'm glad John Lewis ain't going to the inauguration. I'm glad those other Democrats are standing with him. Because I stand with John Lewis too. He is illegitimate. What does that mean? He ain't legitimate. Every president for the last, 30, 40 years has showed their taxes. Not a financial form. And I'll tell you another thing. If he loves this country, he'll reach out to John Lewis. John Lewis don't have to apologize to him. He has a right to question, just like everybody else. Look at all these countries laughing at us. President in training. That's what China said. It's like president trainee. No, he don't know nothing. But I tell you what. Divest. Tell him to divest. I love to see snowflakes or whatever y'all like to call everybody else. Liberal tears. Republicans, I'd love to see y'all get on his Twitter feed and let him know. This is what y'all want. Because if y'all don't, y'all ain't patriots either. And you can call me all type of names. Matter of fact, some dude called me a... he called me a black nigger. Wow, that's like worse than one, right? Listen, man, let me explain something to you. I don't know if your mama told you this, or your daddy, or your grandmothers, or your auntie, your great aunts, your mother slash sister. I don't know. But there was a thing that we learned early on. Real simple. Sticks and stones may hurt my bones or your bones, but words will never hurt you. Big hands. We ain't worried about little words. Words come from behind that keyboard. Be a boss. But anyway, does. And for all y'all that want to, you know, I gave it to you again. Give me a call. 219-512-9910. Let's talk about it. Put your little, dial on the little phone that you're looking at. The little, probably, it don't even, the little flip phone. Yeah. Call me up. State your case. CEO, blackfolkhotspots.com. See, because on Martin Luther King's Day, I need y'all to go read some books. Go read some books on history. Matter of fact, go read some books on black history. Read what the black people in America that were brought to America had to go through. Read that. Read a little bit. Read John Lewis's book, his memoir. Read Martin Luther King's books. Read some of his speeches. I mean, if you can't read them, get them on audio. That way, you know, it can talk to you. Understand. Empathy. I get it. Y'all think this world is leaving. It's leaving you. Barack Obama ain't do nothing but make this country better. But y'all seem to forget. Probably some of y'all ain't even old enough to even know. You know, where this country was, you know, back in 07, 08. You know, stock market like 6,500, the Dow. Losing hundreds of thousands of jobs a month. Yeah, that's what the last Republican did. Repeal and replace Obamacare? You mean Affordable Care Act? So now you won't be able to be on your parents' insurance till you're 26 if you're in college? You know, pre-existing conditions. So you people out in Southern Ohio and West Virginia, you got that black lung from being in the coal mines. Now you can't get coverage. Insurance premiums go up all the time. When I was in high school, the year I was graduating high school, gas was like 75 cents a gallon. You fill up a car for you can ride around all day for $5. That's when gas money was $5. Truly $5. And that was just a short time period ago, 20-some years ago. 27 years ago, to be exact. Well, 26 and a half. Came out in 1990. But does Donald Trump love this country more than he loves money? And if they do manage, and I hope they do come up with a better system. That's what the Affordable Care Act was made for. Barack said that too. If you come up with one, come up with one. Let's work together. He always asked. But no. Mitch McConnell and your boy Mitch McConnell didn't want to work. He told the Republicans, no, we ain't working. We ain't working together. We ain't working. Y'all fell for it. You know why? Because Donald Trump likes the uneducated. Yeah, you. You are deplorable. Look up the definition of deplorable. If you can't spell it, just type it the best way you can and hopefully Google will help you figure it out exactly what it means. Yeah. Or help you with the spelling. Read the definition. Y'all disgust me. Till y'all get knowledge. Understand. Get knowledge. But until then, y'all disgust me. For real. Peace out, y'all. Check out the links in the description. I'm going to post some links to some books. Get you some knowledge. And it's okay. We're a progressive country. This ain't 1776. It's the year 2017. Divide and conquer does not work.
Well, yeah, though.
On people who don't understand. The uneducated. The unintelligent. Weirdos. I swear. Man, y'all gotta get better. Y'all gotta do better. I'm out of here for real this time. Peace.